Pansaari was like a midlife leap off a cliff. It really began because I became pretty concerned about the way we grow food in this country, the sustainable agriculture, and also what was happening in my home state of Rajasthan, where we are running out of water. So it began with an effort to support sustainable agriculture here. As in urban, a lot of young people are moving to urban agriculture and growing food right here in the city. So chai, especially in America, has almost become a flavor. We think of chai as a flavor. Whereas for us in India, chai is a particular kind of tea that's processed differently. Each leaf is crushed, torn and curled. So it's CTC tea. And chai, this tea, needs to be boiled in whole milk. So if you boil it in soy or almond, that's fine, but it will not really be real chai.
I hear about like a lot of chai latte, for example, which is a little bit weird because it's basically like a milk drink with a little bit a fake cardamom taste.
It just has four ingredients. It has whole milk, the chai, fresh cardamom, and sugar. Now there's lots of people who've traveled to India, and when they come and they taste the food, they're like, this is the food we ate when we went to India, we can't get it at an Indian restaurant. And they're curious about our culture.
I normally get brunch with my friends every Sunday after seeing them for church or for just hanging out. And my friend Sujay and I have this tradition. We really like Indian food. He's from India. He has really high standards for Indian food, so we chose Pansaari. If you want something more authentic, more traditional, if you want a good Indian ambiance, that's definitely something I would recommend about this.